Assalamualaikum, Sudin. Now I will explain on the topic project cost management. Yeah. Okay. So when you manage your project, yeah, first thing, one thing that you have to manage, yeah, is the cost of the project lah. So you have to make sure, yeah, your project, yeah, we work within the allocated budget lah, yeah. So that is the most important things, yeah, that you have to manage in your construction, yeah. You have to make sure your works, yeah, which have planned, or construct in the construction within the allocated budget. Yeah, so I straight away go to the slide presentation. Yeah. Okay. So I'm presenting the screen now. Okay. So project cost management. Yeah. Right, so this is the content of the lecture. Yeah, so I will explain one by one. All right, okay. So for the definition of the cost, yeah, cost is the resource, yeah, which we need to sacrifice, yeah, yeah, the client need to sacrifice or foregone, yeah, to achieve a specific objective or something given up to in exchange, yeah. So to complete the project, so you have to sacrifice cost of the project lah, yeah. And it is normally measured in monetary units, meaning that the currency, yeah, of the country, yeah, is depend on the currency of the country, yeah, for that particular project, alright. And then project cost management, yeah, describe the process involved in planning, estimating, budgeting and control the cost to ensure the budget the project, yeah, complete within the approved budget, yeah. So that is the definition. Okay, now we move to project cost management process, yeah. So and project cost management, there are three, yeah, process, yeah, which involve planning and monitoring and control lah, yeah, stage, yeah, in project life cycle, right. So in the planning stage, yeah, it involve estimate cost and determine the budget lah, yeah. And then in monitoring and control phases, yeah, it involve control of the cost, yeah. Okay, so this is the project cost management process, yeah. Estimate the cost, determine the cost and control the cost, right, of the project, right. So estimate cost, yeah. So what is estimate cost? Yeah, estimate cost involve developing approximately of the cost, yeah, of the resource to complete, yeah, each of the scheduled activity in the project, right? So you have to remember, yeah, when you estimate the cost, it will involve risk lah, yeah. So because there is something which is unforeseen, yeah, when you estimate the cost, all right, and then something that may occur in the future, yeah. By example, during the construction, yeah, there are landslide, by example. So the you don't estimate for that cost, yeah, to resolve for the landslide occurrence, yeah. So it's cost involved in resolving and mitigating the risk lah, yeah. So so some of the project, they will allocate the money for the some amount of money for the mitigating and resolving the risk. Yeah, it depend on the project. Yeah, so when you plan for the project, you have to think what is the risk for will involve in your project. Yeah, so you can allocate some amount of money for that. Yeah, but they have to agreed by the clients and all the authority. Yeah, the stakeholder. Okay, so basic tools and technique to estimate the cost. Yeah, there are six of them. Yeah, I will explain one by one. All right, first one is the analogous. Yeah, so this one for the analogous is based on the history of the cost of the project based on history, cost, data or information of the similar project. So it's suitable for the standard design so project which is use the standard design. Yeah, by example in Malaysia, the school project, normally they will use the JKR. Normally school project is under JKR lah. Yeah, so JKR will use the standard design, meaning that standard drawings, for the project, for the school project. Yeah, so you can estimate the cost based on the previous project lah. Yeah, which is similar. Yeah, okay, by example here, the cost of the school block previously, so if in the photo here, figure, so in 2012 when they built the school, is same as what they had going to build in 2014. Yeah, so for the school, when they allocate or estimate the budget for the school in 2014, so they can use the previous data information for the project which has built in 2012, because they use the same drawing, same standard design. Okay, and then six, the bottom up is based on the breakdown of work. So the item or the component involved in the project. By example, a project may be broken down into items such as preliminaries, substructure, building, M&E, and the external works. So the cost may derive from the cost per square meter of the building. So for the building, they will use cost per square meter. By example, if they want to estimate for the house, for example, if you ask the contractor how much is the cost, it will ask you what is the area of the house, so they can kind of come out with the estimate budget lah. Yeah, so it depend on the cost per square meter. Yeah, so normally if for the bungalow, for example, for the bungalow house, now to construct, for the bungalow, now the cost is about RM200 per square meter lah. Yeah, so you can based on the area of the bungalow, then you time 200, then you can get the cost of the estimated cost of the bungalow. Yeah, so percentage allowance is for M&E, preliminaries and external works. So it can use percentage, yeah, percentage from the project lah. So how many percent out of the project, yeah, for they will allocate the budget based on that lah, yeah. And then the third one is parametric, yeah. So based on the characteristic of the project, yeah. So by example, the school project may be estimate based on the cost per bed lah. So how many beds, yeah. So it will estimate the cost by the numbers of bed lah in the hospital, for example, yeah. And the second one, it will estimate the cost, yeah, based on number of the classroom, yeah, right. So there is a parametric, yeah, method to estimate the cost, lah. All right. Then number four, resource cost rate, lah. Yeah. Rate are built up based on the resource required to do the project, yeah, right. For example, yeah, for concreting, the rate are built up from cost of the material, yeah. So the material for the concrete, for example, is cement, sand, yeah, is based on the material, yeah, to estimate the cost, yeah, resource, yeah, resource, yeah. Okay, cost of plant and equipment, yeah, and or cost of the labor, or cost of the profit, overhead and expenses, yeah. So resource of the project, yeah, right. It's based on the resource of the project, lah. If the project is the RC project, so it's based on the made concrete, lah. And the cost will be based on the concrete cost, yeah, right. So depend on the resource of the project, yeah, right. And then vendor bid analysis, yeah. So this one is based on the rate of the rate, yeah, analyzed based on the quotation from the vendor, yeah. Mean that it will based on the tender lah, yeah. The tender which is submitted by the contractor, yeah. So the average of the average or mean of the quotation tender will be cost estimate, lah. Yeah. So if they will use average, yeah, if there are no big difference in the rate among the vendors, yeah, right, and then among the contractor, lah, yeah, or the supplier, for example, it depend on the project, yeah, okay, and the mean, yeah, will be used is one of the window is deemed to have quote out of the normal range, yeah. They will use mean, huh? They will use one of the if one of the vendor, yeah, a quote very high or very low range of the cost, it will use mean, huh? Yeah, to determine the cost of the budget, right. And then to determine the budget, yeah, you will allocating the project cost estimate to the individual work item and provide the cost baseline, yeah. So for example, Ringgit Malaysia, 2.1 million was allocated for land acquisition, yeah, out of the cost of the estimate for the project budgeting purposes, lah. Yeah. So sometimes they will allocate some amount of money, yeah, for the individual works, lah. Yeah, and provide as a cost baseline, yeah, here. All right. So, by example, if for the land acquisition, yeah, it will discuss the stakeholder or team, our project team will discuss what is the budget, yeah, for the land acquisition, by example, and appropriate budget also lah for other component, yeah, sometimes it will determine based on experience, yeah, for the budget, yeah. And land acquisition, sometimes they will ask the land office lah, yeah. The project team will call, sometimes they will call land office representative, yeah, to come and discuss lah, what is the budget. Then I will allocate lah and determine the budget for land acquisition, example, yeah. Okay. And same goes to other component, for example, the utility, yeah, the electric, electrical supply, yeah, they will ask TMB what is the cost, yeah, then they will allocate lah the budget, yeah, for that component, yeah. All right, so this is the example of the extended detail abstract, yeah. Yeah, so after the contractor, yeah, submit the tender, yeah, and the QS will evaluate the tender, yeah, the cost of the project is confirmed, yeah, based on the appointed contractor, yeah, it will use the contractor's budget, yeah. Detail tender, yeah, and provide this one, yeah, as standard detail abstract, yeah. This one is based on the contractor cost lah, yeah, yeah. So QS, yeah, have to prepare 3 detail abstract, yeah. So first one, yeah, before the tender process, yeah, so QS have to prepare preliminary detail abstract, yeah. After tender process, yeah, actually the form is the same, yeah, but for the before the tender process, it prepared by the QS. We call it preliminary detail abstract, yeah. After the tender, yeah, and then the contractor is appointed, yeah, the QS, yeah, will prepare the extended detail abstract, yeah, extender, yeah, meaning that the cost, yeah, based on the what the contractor appointed contractor have been prepared, yeah. So that's one is the extended detail abstract, yeah. And then after the construction, yeah, completed, the QS have to come out with the as completed detail abstract lah, yeah, because sometime in the construction there's some changes then on all the cost here. So the after the completion of the project, the QS have to prepare as completed detail abstract, yeah. So there's a same item, but the cost may be different, yeah, because maybe in the construction there's some changes though. So the QS have to prepare based on the new cost, yeah, for the project, right? Okay, and cost control, yeah, include monitoring cost so in the monitoring and control stage, yeah, you have to control the cost, yeah. So include monitoring the cost performance, yeah. And number two, you have to ensure only appropriate project changes are included in the revised cost baseline, yeah. So you have to ensure the appropriate project changes lah is include in the revised cost baseline, meaning that in your S-curve for the financial, yeah, so you have to consider lah the changes also, yeah, right? Any changes of the work, and it will change the project cost lah, and you have to revise the cost baseline based on the changes, yeah, and the changes have to agree lah, yeah, by the client and the project team, right? And then informing project stakeholder of authorized changes to project that affect the cost, yeah. So any changes of the project, yeah, during the construction stage, yeah, you have to inform lah the stakeholder, yeah. Yeah, for any of the changes that affect the project cost, right? Okay, control cost. So this one I took the example, yeah, from the GKR. Yeah, so this is the example of the cost allocation. Yeah. So for by example here, this is written in Bahasa Melayu because this one I took from GKR. Yeah. So all the government agency, yeah, in Malaysia, they will use Malay lah. Yeah. Right. So they will use Bahasa Melayu. Right. So this one is the month. Yeah. So this is the allocated budget lah. Yeah. And this one is the total cumulative, yeah, for the budget, all right? And this is the percentage, yeah, of the allocated budget, yeah? So this is the actual cost, yeah, for mine, in January, for example. Yeah, this is the total cumulative for the actual cost, yeah? Because for this project, yeah, it involved the previous year, which is 2009. So that's why the cumulative is different from the or from this one, yeah, for January, because there's a previous year the project is ongoing, so that's why the cumulative is different from the allocated budget for each month, yeah. All right, and then this is the percentage, yeah, actual cost percentage, right? And then this is the cumulative for actual work, all right? And then this is the actual cumulative percentage lah, percentage for actual cumulative works, eh? Right? So as an engineer, yeah, you have to prepare this one lah, yeah, so you can see what is the actual, yeah, and the allocated budget, yeah, so what is the difference, yeah, so you can control the cost based on here, right? Okay, and easy for you to present in a meeting also lah, and if you have this one, right? Okay, and then this is the form, yeah, prior approval for change request lah, yeah. So for each of the change requests, yeah, so you have to fill a form, yeah, right? And then this is the example form, yeah, for the adjustment of contract sum for approval change request, yeah. If you have any changes, yeah, or your scope of work, for example, so you have to fill the form lah, yeah, and it have to be agreed, yeah, between the SO, yeah, superintendent officer, and the contractor lah, yeah, yeah. Okay, for the cost closure, yes, to preparation of final account to determine the final cost of the project, yeah. So upon the cost, the project closure, so you have to prepare for the cost closure also lah, yeah. So you have to consider, yeah, to prepare for the final account, yeah. So you have to consider the previous payment made lah, yeah, number one. And you have to consider also the variant order lah, yeah, meaning that any changes you have to you are going to have a VO, variant order. So you have to consider for that also. Yeah. And liquidated and ascertain damage, yeah, LAD. Okay. And then outstanding debt owning, yeah, and number five, adjustment of advance, yeah. So normally, yeah, when the project start, you will have advance payment, yeah. So you have to consider that also, yeah. I think this one is already explained in a cost and estimation, contract and estimation subject, and so this one I think you should familiar lah with all the term, variation order, LAD and advance payment and all that, yeah, right. Okay, and the cost closure, so this is the form, yeah, for the final account, right? Example of the form lah, yeah. This one I took from JKR, nah, yeah. So this is the as complete as I mentioned just now, yeah. After the project completed, yeah, so QS have to prepare as completed detailed abstract, yeah. So this is the form, nah. It will fill in everything, yeah. Here, right. And then the project cost management in project life cycle, nah. Yeah. So after the contractor, yeah. And no, after project manager, yeah, get the letter of authority from the client, yeah, and a project brief, yeah, budget, yeah, yeah, what is the budget of the project, a regulation and the standard, yeah. So the project team, yeah, together with the project manager lah, yeah, to estimate the cost, yeah, in the planning stage, yeah. So as I mentioned, in the planning stage, yeah, the QS have to prepare PDA, yeah. PDA is preliminary detailed abstract, is written here in the notes here, yeah. Okay, and then the second stage, yeah, design stage, determine the budget lah. So normally they will have a value engineering, yeah. So value engineering, they will call a coordination meeting, yeah, with all the stakeholder, yeah. They will discuss about the budget, yeah. All right, they will come out with the estimated cost lah in value engineering process, yeah. So in the value engineering process, they will call all the stakeholder and then have a meeting, okay, and determine the budget lah. All right. But for the value engineering, normally in JKR, yeah, it will involve the project which is cost more than 50 million. It's less than that, the QS will do all the budgeting lah, together with the project manager. All right. And then in the procurement stage, yeah, so the QS, yeah, have to prepare the ATDA lah, which is as standard detail abstract, yeah, based on the contractor cost lah, right. And then during construction stage, yeah, control the cost, so S-curve, yeah, S-curve forecast the expenditure and the actual expenditure lah. So in the S-curve you can see the forecast and the actual expenditure of the project, right. And then during the construction stage, yeah, QS have to revise the ATDA lah, if there is changes, yeah, in the project in the project works, yeah. So you there's there will be changes also in the budget, yeah. So the QS have to revise lah, yeah, the ATDA, yeah, as standard detail abstract, alright. Okay, during the handover, meaning the closure of the project, yeah. So the QS have to prepare the final account, yeah, prepare the elemental cost analysis also, yeah. And then they have to prepare, as I mentioned, the QS have to prepare the as completed detailed abstract, yeah, then closure of the project, yeah, right. So for the summary, yeah, the project cost management is primarily, concerned with the cost of the resource need to complete the project activity lah. Yeah, so you're concerned about the resource, that need to complete the project activity, and cost control is important to be implemented to ensure the project complete in the within the budget lah. So you have to control, that is important for you to control the cost, to make sure the project complete within the allocated budget. So that's all. Thank you for your for listening to the video. All right, so if you have any question, you can ask in the WhatsApp group. Okay, thank you so much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye, student.